All right, what's up, guys? It's just about 4 a.m. Right now. I kind of gotta be quiet because my roommate is literally behind that wall, still sleeping. But today's just gonna be, and from basically here on out, is just gonna be a documentation process of my life, essentially. But mainly my training for HYROX, also just the like personal development of myself, just with the stuff that I do regarding my business, which is personal training, if you don't know, and anything, other projects that I work on, just to document those here as well, just because I want to be able to look back one day. And this stuff is shared, publicly where I can just look back on it. Obviously, for you guys as well, watching the audience, this is something that you'll be able to watch me go through as I go through the process. So, for today, first block of training, I'm gonna have to charge the mics up a little bit, but basically, what we're gonna be doing is just a circuit that's designed for strength and conditioning for HYROX. If you don't know what HYROX is, just think of kind of like a sprint triathlon where you do 8 kilometers of running, but it's split up, and after each kilometer that you run, there's like a different station that you have to complete. So this could be like farmer's carries, this could be the rowing machine, the skiing machine. Burpee broad jumps are a killer. That's kind of what they're known for. But yeah, basically, this is just going to be a documentation process. I'm going to be sharing my life with you guys, just because I think it's something that'd be cool to do. And also, to be honest with you, I think, if you guys stick with me and you watch this, you're going to get a lot out of this. And yeah, I think it's just going to be a great tool to. Hold myself accountable. It will be just cool to look back at the public documentation of, when I was 24, and just to, well, I'll keep this short, but entrepreneurship has a lots of ups and downs, and some days are better than others, some days are worse than others. Today, like I'm running off of, 2, 3 hours of sleep at most, but that's just what it takes some days. You have to stay consistent, and then when you get to a resting point, you can rest, you can fuck off, you can mess around, go to the beach, all that stuff. But for the most part, yeah, a lot of it is work, and a lot of it is ups and downs that not a lot of people want to talk about because they want to be seen as cool, or they want to be seen as they got it all together. But that's not always the case with entrepreneurship. There's lots of ups and downs. And I think documenting those and like sharing those won't only be beneficial and something, nice for me to look back on one day, but also for you guys. Like if you're going through that phase, kind of what Alex Hormozi talks about, like the lonely chapter, where you don't really fit in necessarily with your current friend group, but you don't have the outcomes of being in that more successful network and that next level. Of course, you're kind of like in and out of both, it feels like at times, because you're like breaking through to that next level. But you guys, if you're watching this and you're feeling like that, or you feel like you maybe even want to try to go for something like that, you're going to get a lot from this channel. So welcome to the ride. Really all I got in store this morning, like I said, I probably have to charge these mics up a little bit just because they've been like sitting in my room. I've had them for a long ass time. I just haven't done anything with them. So charge these mics up, just check my blood sugar. I might get a little food in before the gym, but probably just like caffeine. I pretty much train, I'm comfortable with training fasted. I'm comfortable with training fueled. it really does not make that much of a difference. I'd say my performance is a little bit better when I'm fueled up, but yeah, I'm just gonna check my blood sugar, get some water and get a little caffeine in, charge these mics, and then head to the gym. So today we basically just have quick, like miniature HYROX circuit. That's like a 500 meter row, and then 15 kettlebell deadlifts. Don't really try to take too much of a break between those. Just a consistent pace for all the rowing. It doesn't have to be anything that's drastically pushed, a little bit more of like a zone two feel to it. But start off with 500 meter row. Then we're gonna go into 15 kettlebell deadlifts. Do those as unbroken as possible. So no big breaks or anything like that. Get through those kettlebell deadlifts. And then we're gonna go into 20 burpees. Technically, according to what I wrote, I'm supposed to go do 20 wall balls for those, but the way this gym is set up, it's just like gonna be a lot of moving around for that. So burpees are another like weak point of mine, you could say, when it comes to HYROX. I think that's a lot of people too, is they struggle with the burpees. The wall balls at the very end, it's just a killer for a lot of people because they put the wall balls at the end of the competition. But we're already at 250 meters on a row, 230 pace, and we're going to do four rounds of this. So we'll see how long it takes. We'll just go from there, but pick up the pace a little bit on the rowing. I don't really do any fancy warm-ups or anything at all. Like this is my, I just get straight into it, I don't really need to stretch too much. You can do like a dynamic stretching routine if you want, but you don't have to do too much. And also I'm curious to see what this is like with like the background music, if that's like all y'all can hear, or if you can actually just hear my voice in the mic. So we'll see how well it goes. Okay. Last 40 meters, I'm at like a 220 pace, 225. So nothing major. Okay, 500. Okay, so now just 15 kettlebell deadlifts as consistently as possible. Take a little bit of a break just to catch your breath, and then I'm gonna do 20 burpees, and we'll do farmer's carries down and back after this to the end of the mat. Cool. You're kind of cooking me a little bit. So it's just gonna be three more rounds of that. Like I said, I kinda like I rested for about 30 seconds. You can still see I'm kinda breathing hard. But kinda treat the row as your recovery for this. So we'll go ahead and get right into that. If you want to know what a Hyrox feels like, doing this circuit will definitely give you that feeling, because minus the running, that was, you know, three of the exercises that you have to do. So there's farmer's carry, there's a row, and there's burpee broad jumps. No jumps on the burpees today, but that will give you a good feeling of what it feels like to do a Hyrox. It's just all condensed. So get back to rowing 500 meters, just kind of like a medium, you know, comfortable, good pace, just to recover, also do some work. Rowing is definitely, like, for your competition, especially for when I did my first doubles with Cody, the rowing is like where you get the break in the competition for sure, because we just split it up. I did 500, he did 500, but that was the easiest part of the competition for sure, was just that rowing section. Meters, like 220 pace again. Definitely feeling it. Got 20 meters to go. Finishing like at a 230 pace. Like I said, the rowing is just kind of what I treat
as a recovery phase for this, because rowing will definitely be the easiest part of your competition. It's not bad, but you'll definitely get cooked if you don't work on the other stuff. Recover a little bit, but 20 burpees, just kind of keeping it as unbroken and consistent as possible, but you'll be good. Cool. Should be 20. So that's round two, round three now. As you can see, burpees for a lot of people, but for me too, I mean, burpees just kind of take it out of you. But back to another 500 meters. One thing that I find really interesting with the Hyrox race is just kind of the wide range that you have of like people that are actually there competing and people that are just there to like, I guess participate is the best way to describe it, but I think it's always good to like push yourself and compete for something, no matter what that is. And me making these videos will just kind of be part of that process, because y'all will get to see the buildup to everything from now to race day, and just see how I do with all of it, see where my progress is at. Because, man, the biggest like sin you can commit in your life is just not pushing yourself enough, you know? Like, everything you want is already inside of you. You just have to have enough balls to go out there and like take action and actually do it. You can't fake any of it. People see through the fake bullshit and stuff, so it all just has to be real and genuine with your intentions of what you're trying to build, what you're trying to do with your life, and you'll attract the right people. You'll attract the right energy back into your life with that. All right, 350 meters, 220 pace. Pretty solid. I mean, it could be a little bit better. At 400. Maybe 440. Into kettlebell deadlifts again, 15 of these. Need fucking chalk, bro. Big thing with the High Rocks competition too is like, bro, it's just your legs. Like, your legs get cooked twice as much as your upper body because you're running, and then over half the stuff you do, I feel like, is mostly lower body. All right, burpees. So last round, really the goal now, because like y'all can see like on my burpees, definitely the weakest thing, but the goal for these is just keeping the pace as consistent as possible. So even though I would like to rest some more before I start rowing, that's not how it's going to be in the race. You can't, especially for a training session like this, you can't wait until you're like just 100% recovered to start training, like to start your next set, start your next round. Otherwise, you're not going to make any improvements. It's like if you were to rest to 100% recovery on every set, you'd be in the gym for like twice as long. And then on those days when you're supposed to go really intense, bro, you'll be in there for way, way, way too long. And plus, it's not gonna help you get the benefits that you're actually looking for if you're training like that. Like, obviously I'm breathing heavier, sweating. That's what you're looking for, and that's what you want with this. You don't wanna have a workout that's just a breeze, you know? You can maybe have one of those once a month, maybe once every 2 weeks, just to run through everything and lube everything up. But as a rule of thumb now, all right, so at 290, 230 pace. But yeah, what I was saying earlier is just the energy that you give out in the world is always gonna be what you get back 100%. And you typically get it back like tenfold. So if you treat people really well and put your best out there, it's gonna come back like 10x. And it's not immediate, like it can take months or years. You know, like the content that I'm posting today, or like the content that I even posted, you know, 2 to 4 years ago, that influences how people interact with me today, you know? So that's always just something to keep in mind, keep out there. All right. So 238 pace, 500 meters. Not the best, but we're gonna make improvements on that. So kettlebell deadlifts again, and then we're gonna hop back into our burpees and then farmer's carries. I'm resting too long, I'm being a bitch. Seven. right. Gonna maneuver around them, but knock out these farmer chairs. Done. All right, cool. So, I mean, as y'all can see, got pretty cooked, got the sweat all on one of the hats that one of my clients gave me. Shout out Corey. But, dude, solid workout. It kind of cooked me. Definitely the burpees were getting my ass. But that's the point of doing this, is also not only to improve, but you can identify your weak spots. So as I prepare for this competition, I already know from day one, okay, what were my weaker points? Obviously, you know, can definitely use some work on just my conditioning in general, but burpees for sure. Kettlebell deadlifts were not really a problem. Same thing with farmer's carries. And the biggest thing to remember for the competition is you are gonna be fatigued. You know, so a big part of training for this is compromise runs, compromise lifts. So that's where you would go out, intentionally kind of beat up your legs before you go lifting, or vice versa. So you go get a lift session in, kind of beat up your legs, and then you go for some longer runs. That's going to be a big part of my training. I'm going to be running tomorrow. I don't know how long, but probably for about 45, 30 minutes of just some running. See, you know, the distance that I get on that. Probably won't film that too much. I'll just upload something else for you guys, because to me it's kind of pointless to like go out and film an entire, you know, 45 minute run when I won't even want to talk to you guys, probably won't even be able to talk to you guys. So I'll still upload something, but yeah, let me know what you guys think about this. I'm gonna keep doing it regardless, just because it's a good way for me to publicly document the process, like I said. But let me know what you think. Let me know what you want to see. Also, let me know too, since I'm working towards this, what are you guys working on towards the gym? Just leave a comment. I reply to all my comments. You know, my channel's pretty small right now. I have like 400 something subscribers. So take advantage of that as much as you can, because, you know, I don't know where this is going to go. I'm hoping it blows up and it gets big. But yeah, just going to document the process. I'll see you guys in the next one.